Yeah, good. It was under 10. So now I'm just going to continue. This will be a new video. We won't have to edit it, hopefully. So yeah, my plan was to help a person experience the realness of the greater reality by using this hypnagogic imagery, the ability to have lucid dreams, visualization abilities that are really par excellence relative to most people. So I did that, and the way I do it is I'll take the person who does have visual abilities already, and they're like a 7, 8, or 9 on a visualization scale where 1 is you can just barely see imagery at all, and 5 is it's kind of thin, but you can see vivid imagery, our imagery. It's not very vivid. Mental, you know, like imagine an apple or think of your car outside parked. And, you know, there's how substantial your imagery is, and then there's the duration of your imagery. Some people, like myself, the imagery is not substantial. It's more like a 35 millimeter slide. You know, it's see-through. It's very thin. And it's also very short duration. I mean, my stuff is there and gone, there and gone. It's like there, and I can remember what I just saw when I think of my car parked out there. It's gone, but I saw it, and I can, you know, it's fresh in my mind. So then I'm back into mental thinking about the image that I just saw. But other people have the ability to imagine or remember their car, bing, and not only is it vivid, but it's persistent as an image. They can see it, and they can just look at their image all day long. Now, most people don't talk about this and talk about other people's visual ability skills or their recall of music or sound. I have a cousin. He listened to a conversation during the day, and he can play that conversation word for word, inflection. Every word that's said, what he says and what the other person says, he hears it again in his head. Now, a lot of people that are musical know this. They, yeah, you can. Well, you make up music in your head. You can remember music. You can hear a song, and you can, you know, you hear every note, and it just plays. What's the problem? Well, not everybody can do that. Same with visualization skills, visualization stuff. Not everybody can do it. So, and I certainly can't, but I do know some of these training techniques or these spiritual development techniques or coaching techniques that will help a person with their spiritual growth and development in this way. And my fascination is with consciousness shifting into the higher planes and out of this matrix. So I've been using all these ideas together to help a person do this. Now, I have taken a person, we'll call her Rachel, and we worked together for quite a while. And so I'd have Rachel on the phone. She's in another state somewhere. We're talking back and forth. And I'm coaching her on this stuff. So I get her to relax, Rachel, and relax. And we're going to get her to that place where she can start seeing hypnagogic imagery. So she starts seeing the imagery. And then I'll have her, you know, as soon as it comes in, okay, she's going to try to, you know, grab onto an image and hold it there. And if she can, we'll do some work on it. If she can't, I'll say, okay, when you see an image come in, bat it away. Okay. She knocks away some images, you know, in consciousness. She's just kind of pushing away. And she would do this for a little bit until some images would come in. They would be more substantial, and they would stay longer. So, good. That's what we want. We want hypnagogic imagery that will stay with us so we can work with it. And so I'll have her see the image. Let's say she sees she sees green grass, some bright green bushes, and some yellow rose bushes. It could be anything, but let's say that's what it was. Okay, and so now it's staying there. And I said, okay, well, can you move closer to the roses? And yeah, because it's just manipulating your mental imagery, right? And so she does that a little bit, back and forth, and then I'll have her look at the ground and notice, oh, well, there's some dirt here, and there's a little bit of grass, and it's very clear. It's got that hypnagogic vividness to it, right? And now it's more and more substantial. Well, in my theory and understanding of what we're doing here is we're helping a spiritual being actually create a world around them, just like we do it subconsciously here in the physical world. But this is practice creating your own world consciously. So how do you take it from hypnagogic imagery or vivid imagery to an out-of-body experience in your own self-created world environment? This is how I do it. I have them, when they're looking at the ground, after a little bit, I'll have them look at their feet. I say, do you see your feet? And they go, oh, yeah. Yeah, there's my feet. And I ask them if they got shoes on or barefooted, what, and they describe their shoes and all that. And then I'll do a little bit more out in the environment because it's a little easier and more safe and secure than looking at your hands. Because this person isn't, they're not, it's not like you're up and ready to look at hands when you see your mental imagery. You just, hey, I'm just looking at my imagery. Well, when you look at hands, it starts getting you the idea that, whoa, if I'm seeing my feet and my hands, I might have a body here. So we gradually take the person into this new awareness and understanding of the possibility of this is not just 3D imagery, but they have a body here too that they're creating or imagining that they have. So we do this for a little while, and over the course of an hour or two or three, or over the course of several sessions over a period of a week or two, because this is all about spiritual growth and development. This isn't a, you know, this isn't a one-time fast, oh look, oh we did. Sometimes it works real fast in one session, sometimes it doesn't. But this is a way to help people understand the greater reality and consciousness shift and become flexible and be able to move out of this matrix and into it, out of it, at more with more free will. And once you can do this, you can learn more about the other planes of existence, what's really going on out there. We've got extraterrestrials that understand this basic concept here. I believe that humans, we have more innate ability and more psychic ability and spiritual ability to create and move and shift in these other planes of existence than most of the extraterrestrial races. And they can't do that. They have to rely upon the kundalini, they have to rely upon the pineal gland, chemistry, body, psychotropic drugs or electronic phenomena to get the vivid imagery going. And they can tweak it and mess with it, but they really don't get it, and it doesn't come natural, or it's not something that they can develop within their system naturally. But we as humans, we can. It's not developed in us, but we can. We have that that potential, where these ET guys don't. That's one of the reasons they really like our bodies, and that's they want us and our bodies and the whole thing. Okay, but moving back to getting us consciousness shifting out of body using the hypnagogic imagery, you have the person start seeing their hands and then start touching things. Now, as they start touching things, their ability to actually feel it becomes more real. Now, what you're doing in the big picture is you are drawing more and more attention and consciousness of this spiritual being. While doing these processes, you're drawing that consciousness into a new focus and a new viewpoint in their non-physical body that they're touching the tree with. They're looking at the yellow roses from this non-physical body viewpoint. They are touching the tree. I'll have them look at the ground. I'll have them stomp on the ground. I'll have them look up at the sky. I'll have them walk through the environment, move around, turn around, look 360 around and around. And what you're doing is you're getting this person able to detach from their physical world environment, and the consciousness, literally, the full consciousness shifts into a non-physical reality created system. And the more consciousness you have in an environment, the more real it is. It just, you are here, and you know it. You know who you are, and you know that you're here. And you go, oh, you know that you are, and you know you are here. And you go, wow, I really am here. And you're touching it, and you can taste it. You can smell it. And if you're interacting with people, you can feel their emotion. It's really great with love, because you can feel how much love there is, and it's just really wonderful. So this is how it works, and we're going to have to wrap it up right now, okay? Talk to you more later. Bye-bye.